What's up, summoners?
Lucifer is here with another episode. Quest to complete free-to-play farmable teams. We're going to go for Carryout Dungeons. We're going to run through some Carryout Dungeons this episode. We are going to... Giants, Dragons, and Necro. For Giants, this is a team I'm using with them currently. Let's see here. Lapis. Sig. Varimos. Shannon and Bernard. Or do we want to go for... Oh, this should work. No healer. We'll add in a healer next. Well, actually, Varimos heals. His passive heals the entire team. Bernard, we're going to use for our speed boost and our attack bar increase, attack gauge, attack bar increase. Shannon, defense buff as well as attack buff. Sig does damage based on the enemy's HP. Then we have his AoE, which is a stun, Varimos is a stun, we have Lapis, she's on Despair, so she's gonna stun. She also self heals with skill 3, complete AoE, defense breaks. Bernard, he defense breaks and attack breaks. Shannon slows attack speed, as well as increases the chance of landing a glancing hit. And you also have the dots coming from Vero. Vero's on the violent energy. This is attached based on his speed and HP and violent, so you can proc. Get an extra turn. So we see this works. Speed. I don't know. If I had a percentage enter, maybe I'd keep it, but. Alright, let's see here. Prepare. We'll take out Bernard. Actually, leave Bernard in. Take out Lapis. Put Sig as lead. And we'll bring in Bella. Probably slower. All of these monsters are fusible. Well, 2 are fusible, 3 are farmable. You can even farm them to a second awaken. I'm going to give him a little extra punch like I have. They don't need it to run a Giants B-10. Nora does the defense break, remove beneficial effects. Increases attack gauge as well as heals. I've been working on getting together. I've been farming dungeons, farming arena, so we can get, as well as leveling the monsters for the next areas, which would be rifts. Got ready for double S on Wind Rift, Water Rift. Trying to work on Fire Rift, but that's another episode. Works. Now let's say you have yet to fuse Baronos or where's Lulu? Here's Lulu. Lulu. Who else? Should work. So we have Lapis replacing Sig. Sigamores and Lulu replacing Baramos. Lulu heals your monsters on your team with every attack, because it's passive. But it only heals one monster, and that is the one with its lowest HP on your team. It also does debuffs and puts on immunity. If your team had no debuffs, if one of your monsters had a debuff, it would just remove the debuff and not put the immunity on it. But if the entire team had no debuffs, it'll heal and throw immunity on it. With debuffs, remove immunity, heal that one monster. I mean, remove the debuff, not place immunity, heal that monster and heal the rest of the team as well as putting the immunity on the other team monsters in your team that did not have a debuff. Skill 2 heals the monsters, your team. I put Shannon on shield, swift. That way, every turn, every wave, they automatically start with a shield, and then she builds up her defense buff. So they take less damage through the beginning, so they can start rolling out their buffs. Increase attack speed, attack bar, get the debuffs on them on Giant, and then just go out and attack. This ain't the fastest teams. By far not the fastest teams. But they work. And that's what we want. We want a high success rate. Starting out. That's all you want to worry about, is high success rate. So you're not wasting energy. Because you're free to play, right? Let's see here. I'll take out Lulu. Darian. Sig. Vero in, and this is perfect. Fuse Vero, farm for Darian. You're going to need him for R5 and R4 anyhow, so get him. Then you're going to have Bella. You're going to need Bella for a lot of your rift teams. Shannon and Bernard. And you definitely want to go ahead and get Bernard's. They have second awakening for Griftons, and Bernard is great with second awakening. This was my first team. This is the team I started out with. I think I have Darian on shield as well. Yes, I do actually. I want to see a Lulu second awakening. That would be what's up. Lulu second awakening. That'd be awesome. Or Yeti. Yeti second awakening. Because I built a Yeti for built the Wind Yeti for Water Rift. Tested out the team, works great. Get S, at least S every time. Every time. Alright, this will be our last run here. Because next you would take out Darien, have a few Sig, and put Sig in place. Speed up the team. And if I would say if Lulu hit as hard as Vermos and left dots, I would say you wouldn't have to fuse Sig. You can just put Lulu in the place of Sig. But then you wouldn't have no leader skill. Well, in the place of Baramos, you could put Lulu. And this would be a team, but you can't do that because no leader skill and not enough attack damage, or even no dots to at least take down the music, boss's HP. We will move to dragons. Dragons. By here, you should already have Vero and Sig. Then, as we can see over here, fusion. You can fuse Verdehill. Verde. So that is one of the monsters we will use, along with Sig and Vermos for dragons. This team I still use. It's successful. I've tried replacing monsters with like Quinn Water Monkey King. Route, Rogue, whatever you, however you want to call them, placing with a bunch of different monsters just doesn't work. But this team here works. And during dragons, you're also working on fusing Vermos and Sig, and farming for Bell. Shaman's already 6-star, possibly second awakening. And then you just need to also farm and fuse with Verda. Verdehill. Verde. Verde. That's how this team here works. You have Verde as speed lead, as well as increasing attack gauge with every attack. Self heal. Then you have Shaman. Bringing in the shield, because of the shield runes, increasing attack gate, increasing the attack, as well as defense. And you have Vermos removing any debuffs and healing the team every time, as well as bringing in stuns and dots. Then you have Sigmaris doing a single target freeze, or an AoE freeze, and a single target stun. And every attack, well, No, not every attack. Skill 2 and 3 are based on the enemy's HP, which is great for the boss. And then, of course, you have Bella here, healing your team, ensuring they stay alive. Removing the immunity from the dragon that the right crystal puts on the dragon. It's a strip. Bring it in defense break. Defense break. And with the hill, increasing attack gauge. So your 2 attack gauge increases going on here. You have Shannon doing it on their second awakening, doing a attack gauge reduction on the boss, as well as when she does her AoE, she slows the speed down on every unit, every enemy, both crystals, the boss, as well as attack bar reduction, so slows attack bar, reduces. Awesome. She also does the glancing hit, so the team is perfectly synchronized for each other. So see, there you are, dots from the boss. Ramos comes in, passively removes it. A lot of people say Fran. No, not Fran. No. Passive debuff remover. And AoE heal every debuff or dot. Any cleansing he can do with his passive, he also heals with his passive the entire team. There's no need. Not the fastest team. Not the fastest team by far, but it is successful. That's what you want. Now, instead of Fran, which I don't consider Fran to be farmable, we did that in the last episode. Why? Because Fran, you need events that drop ancient coins. What if an event that you're on doesn't drop any ancient coins? What if they stop doing events? Hang out. We'll put Lulu in. Lulu works just as great. Not as much, doesn't have the passive cleanse and heal, AoE heal, but he does have a passive heal on the most of the world's HP. So, plus skill 3, cleanses, puts up immunity on the entire team unless one of the monsters has a debuff, and that monster will not get a immunity, but he will be cleansed and healed along with the rest of the team. Skill 2, heals, I believe it's just Lulu, let's pause this. Removes all harmful effects and target ally recovers both your HP and the target's HP. So it recovers a single target that's HP plus itself. Which is still really freaking good. Especially when you already have Bella in here to do the Lulu's just in here for the cleanse, basically. This we'll do Lapis instead of Sig. Because Lapis is farmable. You get her from your, it's a reward. Maybe it's not even a farm, really a farm. You know, you get her as a reward, which is awesome. Still think her stats need to be buffed. Skills left the same, stats buffed. Speed. Speed, attack, HP, maybe a little bit of defense buff, but definitely attack, speed, and HP. She's a magical knight. Not much armor on, so she should be a lot faster than she is. She's a magical knight, she should have start with a good, decent base accuracy. Boom. Boom. There it goes. There it goes. Boom. Alright, now let's go for Lapis. If you didn't fight Fuse instead of Fire Bombs, here you go. No Fran. Oh, I Fran. I'm still debating on even building a Lauren. Give it into the meta. Because that meta's about to be gone. So I can just see it. Been a meta for quite some time now. Usually after they've been a meta for a little for a good amount of time, they're gone. This one may be slower. Because you don't have Sig doing damage based on the enemy's HP. Lapis has good runes, but she ain't. She has farmed runes. There we go. Farmed. And with this team here, you can replace Lulu with Veramos if you've used Veramos. Verde, don't skip on using Verde for this team. Don't. I'm going to get as many turns in before that right shield throws that immunity. As soon as it throws that immunity, you have to run your stripper, actually stripping the immunity from the dragon. And if it fails, well, now you have to fight through that immunity just to land an attack. There's the defense break. Oh yeah, and we have Lapis doing an AoE attack bar reduction also. So we have 1, 2, 3 units doing attack bar reduction. Two of them does an AoE attack bar reduction. And then we have third skill for Lapis, increases her own attack bar, as well as does an attack bar reduction. It's actually an absorption. She absorbs the attack bar. And we have Verde Hill increasing the attack bar, and Bella here increasing the attack bar every hill. Not the fastest team, but it is successful. 2 minutes, 41 seconds. I mean, again, not the fastest, but it is decent. Shield. It's a blue rune, no speed. Resistance crit rate. So. Alright. Now we will go to Necro. Then the next episode, I'm going to hit on Hall of Magic and all the halls, all of the elemental bosses. This team, here's what I've been using. It's my fastest team right now. So we're going to use Fire Painter, which is not Zhang Fei. Colleen. Throw in Lapis. Where are you at, Lapis? See who else. Verde. You know, the damage dealer. Farmable. Damage dealer. That does AoE. That does multi hits. try a route. A road. I'll try. I haven't used heavy Emma's team before, but possible to work. I know we get the ways fairly easy. Second leaving out. And you want to do these dungeons in the order. You want to go from giants to dragons to Necro, because they each give you the runes you need for the next one. If you need Swift, for instance, Swift from dragons, so you can be faster than that right crystal. This is really fast, actually. It's kind of a good amount of speed to it. So you want to outspeed it, so you can get as many hits in on the dragon as possible. You may even have to start out by hitting that right crystal here. Jean-Fay brings in his basically revenge. He attacks every time he gets attacked, which decreases that shield. And with every OE, ensuring that the shield is decreased. He also brings in an AoE heal per turn. You have Colleen doing an AoE heal. AoE attack bar increase. Also heal block. Verde increasing attack bar. Lapis decreasing attack bar. This is going to be a slow team, by the way. Even if it succeeds, what it is that you want every unit on the team to be a multi. No singulars. Ralph, I can't really consider him a multi hit because it's RNG. You know, it's not an automatic multi hit every time. This works though. It'll be a freaking long ass freaking run. Oh man. Nope. We're not gonna last. That rock is the second waking. Failed. Alright, so we can't use it. Tennis. She's farmable. Fusible. Every attack she does is a multi hit. She also brings in Hawk beneficial effects. I believe so. Attack bar decrease. And her silence. Silence is a... It blocks them from using skills. My bad. Blocks them from using skills. When they attack, she does the increased attack bar. Her skills 2 and 3 are do damage based on the enemy's max HP. Just being in despair right now is gonna bite me in the butt. Alright, come on, Shannon. I mean, Colleen. There we go. There we go. HP block, speed reduction. Time to see you get through this. We've already really removed Southern Turf. Removed the defense break and the speed reduction. Get her out of there, and boom, and out. Get a few hits in, and out of there. Gosh dang it. There we go. Now we just got taken down again. If we can survive from this lapis. This team set up perfectly. I can't remember. Let's see. Let's try that. Instead of the extra defense, let's go 4 speed. This team should work. It's worked before. Yeah. always gets me is how tanky the Lapis is, but how slow she is. So when he pulls, when the Necromancer pulls her, possesses her, it takes a lot longer to leave her. She's my... Oh, sorry. She's my farming unit. Yes, and also I want to apologize for the delay on this next episode of the series. Dealing with a lot of at-home personal issues. Plus that school, my kid, work. But I'm making the video now. Get her out of here. Alright. Oh yes, and right up the road from, WDRB, a new local news channel in my area, there's a church decided they were going to open their doors. WDRB got on that quick. Like, I get it. I get it. It sucks. Alright, this sucks being quarantined. I'm an essential employee where I work, so I have to be there. I provide medical gases to hospitals and places like medical facilities, so I have to be there. Medical, like, oxygen, medical grade oxygen, nitrogen, medical grade nitrous. So, we have to be. But if you're not a central employee, stay home. If you're thinking about going to a friend's house, don't. Stay home. How much do you actually care for your friend? Care for your friend enough to ensure that you two don't get each other sick? Could you live with yourself if you went and got your friend sick and they died? Do you really love your friend then? Sorry. Now, if you want to go practice your religion, your body is the church. The place that you call a church is just a building. It's not the church. Your church is this. This is your church. Where you can worship anywhere you want. You can sit on the toilet, take a dump, and practice your religion. Because you are the church. So, stay home. If you're going to the grocery store, okay, buy in bulk. If you need cigarettes or going to the gas station, you need these things, buy in bulk. There's the team that I was working with. That is the order. It's the only team I could think of for free-to-play Farmables. There may be more. This is the team that I found that worked. I needed to put Verne as the lead for speed. Alright, and I'm going to go ahead and show you the monsters that I'm working on. Rauk, went ahead and 6-starred Rauk. And Second Awakened, 6-starred Grouch. And Second Awakened. Who else did we go for? Of course, we have Noramon. 6-star Second Awakened. Rakaja, the Wind Yeti. Here's why the Wind Yeti. Here's what you want to be building in your Wind Yeti for. Skill 3. Recovers the HP of all allies proportion to the number of surviving allies. Recovery of 10-20%. An extra 10-20%. Scroll down the time, down to 3. That's awesome. You pair that with your front line of Bernard Shannon. Perfect. Then you have a rain for water, as well as the pinnace. And who else? Because we're trying to build an entire wind team. I think I'm still actually working on the water. But for the wind rift, we built. Where is she? Callie? Increases attack power and attack speed of all allies for 2 turns, becomes invincible for 1 turn. Which is great. Does a force skill, you can get a cooldown turn time on this skill of 4 turns. Here's the one I really like. Strikes the enemy with an attack strong enough to split the earth. Ignores the enemy's defense to inflict significant damage in 3 turns. Plus it has a 25% damage multiplier. Add it when you skill her up. Hits the enemy with an energy blast and inflicts continuous damage for 3 turns with 20% damage, whatever. Haven't max skilled her for the harmful effect rate. Not really worried about that. More worried about the damage. Of course, these 2, so it's 3. Colleen. And Young Fett. Works perfect. Yeah, 1, 2. 3, 4, 5. And then we also put in Bella. Whatever my Bella is. What? There's Bella. Bella. This team works great. Fire. We're working on Casey. Here's why. Some shooting stars that attacks enemies randomly, they inflict the damage increases as the same target gets hit again. Attacks all enemies, decreasing their attack speed for 2 turns with 80% chance on each target. Which is awesome. 2 AoEs. Lulu and Colleen. Lapis. Sig. Where is Sig? So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. I want to try Farmable for 6, but his AoE doesn't have 3 turns, maybe. I'm trying to think of another free-to-play or farmable free-to-play monster to use that has an AoE. Figure it out after we get Casey finished, we get Casey built. If anything, I'll try Varimos to see how that works. Yes. These. And that is it for this episode 2 of Quest 2 Free to Play Farmable Teams. Good night, good day, good morning, whatever. You have a good day. And peace out, summoners.